How you doing, everyone? It's Kevin. I'm back with another video. Today we're going to be working on one of our LED lights. One of the switches, the pull string switch went bad. And we're going to go ahead and pull this apart and see if we can put a new one in place of that one there. Because it's still a really good light. The pull string just pulled out of it. And you know, I think the newer these things get, the cheaper they are. They just don't build things like they used to. So you have to learn to replace this stuff so you don't have to replace the light. The lights today are very expensive. These little 3-foot light LED lights are actually pretty expensive. So what we're going to do is we're going to be changing that switch in there. So you're going to need yourself a new switch. And we got a new one here. We're going to be putting in here. You're going to need a flashlight and a screwdriver, and I'm not sure what else, because I've never actually changed one like this before. I'm not even for sure that I can change it, but we're gonna do it on video and we're gonna bring you guys along. So let's see how it works. So the first thing you wanna do is look down in the end of here, and you'll find out you have two little Phillips screws down inside of here, and you may need a flashlight to see that. I've already looked down in there and I know mine's Phillips, so we're going to go ahead and unscrew these two bolts right in here. So just slide your screwdriver down in there and go ahead and pull these two little screws out. Like I said, I've never changed one of these before, so it's always a first time for everything. I'd rather buy a $4 switch than a $40 light. Okay, there's one screw. So we're gonna pull this guy out of here a little bit. Let's just look down in there and see what it looks like. Pretty simple little setup. Looks basically like the same switch that we got. So we're going to go ahead. We're gonna pull this guy off of here. That just unscrews. And then we should be able to pull this out of here. So now we got our switch out. Be nice if we could tear the switch apart and put the chain on there. So you know what? We might try to do that instead of wasting a whole switch, because you can see the chain is clearly broke right up inside there. So I'm going to see if I can pull this guy apart. I might be able to. We're going to try it. What's the worst we could do is break it? If we could get this little cover off of here. I'm not sure if it's made to come off. Okay, we got one off. Okay, we got two off. Pretty simple setup here, actually. Now, let's see if this comes out. Probably never get it back together. Right there's the chain that broke right there. And I see how it's locked in there. We should be able to pop that guy right back out of there. Maybe. Right there. I'm gonna go see if I got some more chain. Okay, I got a piece of chain here. So we'll slide that chain, huh? I guess we'll have to try this out first. See if we can get it to work. Okay,
Now we have to lock our chain up in here, which this chain might be bigger. It is much bigger. I got the chain in there, but it's tight. So now we got to get this thing to spring back in there. I have to figure it out. Okay, I see how that works. Then we'll have to... find out where this goes. Down inside of there. Twist it around. Alright, I got it down in there and I got the clip in there. Now we just have to get this guy back on there where it goes. This is not very easy. Remembering how it goes is the hard part. Like that. Okay, our spring is back in there. Whether it'll work or not, I don't know. So we gotta get these guys back in here. These little wires, if you guys can see that. These little wires clip on there. They just slide into them slots right there. Slide straight in. Make sure they're pushed down. And then, see how this went. Goes on this way. This is something you just have to kind of go with the flow and figure it out as you go. Especially if you've never done it before. Okay. Well, it's working. Now I gotta get this thing off the end of here. So now we got our switch. The chain back in there. Now it can be done, as you guys seen, we just did it. And then we gotta fish our chain back up through the hole. How to get this guy back in here. It's tight. It is very tight in there. So once we got our chain up there, get our little bolt nut put back on here. Get it screwed on. Okay, now that's back on. We should be able to slide our wires back up in here. Get all of our wires back up in here and hopefully slide this thing back together. It's going to be a little tight here. Got to get your wires all tucked up in there. Now that we got our wires back up in there and everything seems to be pretty good, we're going to go ahead and slide our bolts back in here and get them snugged up. Since building the new house, the barn dominium, we've actually had a lot of issues with different lights. You know, these LED ones, like I said, it seems like they just kind of are cheap made, but they're not cheap to buy. So now our little switch, our chain is back on. The big test is, will it work? So let's get it plugged in and see. Okay, we have our light plugged in. We'll go ahead and turn it on. As you see, the switch works fine. A little heavier chain this time than last time, but that doesn't mean it's not going to break again, because these chains are forever breaking. And we didn't have to use the new switch that we had bought, but we're going to put that on the pegboard, and I'm sure one of these other lights here in the garage or in the house is going to break one, and we'll have one on stock for the next time one goes bad. Now, it only took a couple little tools to do that. I had a little flathead screwdriver, a little Phillips screwdriver, and then I had this little ice pick, and that's about all it took to change that chain out of that switch. Now, a little tedious getting that spring and everything back in that switch so it can work, but it can be done. You've seen it do it right there. I don't think you'll have any trouble. Just pay attention to how you tear it apart. Anytime you tear something apart like this, it's better off if you have a picture of it, take pictures of it before you pull it apart, and then take pictures of it as you're tearing it apart so you can go back to them pictures and see what went where. So take pictures or video, and I think you'll be fine. You'll be able to change your own switch. So I would like to tell everyone, thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe. Leave me thumbs up, thumbs down, or comment if you'd like. Till next time.